Hello everyone, welcome back. Now we are going to show you a new ADC, that is ADS1114. And to gain more knowledge about this ADC, let's proceed to controleverything.com. And here we have to search on for this ADC, that is ADS1114. And let's see what we got here. And here we are with this ADC, and it's a 16-bit two-channel precision analog to digital converter. And there is a long list of features which is onto the screen, and you can also purchase this ADC right from here. Well, I will be interfacing the ADC, that is ADS1114, with a Raspberry Pi and a Java code. It will be the software platform, and let's go to resource tab, and here we are with the Java code sample. Now you can get the Java code sample as a zip file right from here, from this website, and you can also have the code from github.com, and the repository there is Control Everything Community. Now we need to put up some connections for the hardware, and let's see how we do that. Well, in the hardware setup for the connections, what do we require is this Raspberry Pi, which you are able to see on my screen. And these are the GPIO pins of the Raspberry Pi. Next, we require an I2C shield, which you can see, and it's available on the website controleverything.com. The real reason we are using this shield is to make easier connections with other I2C devices. So for that, gently place the I2C shield over the GPIO pins of the Raspberry Pi and make a connection. Next, we need to power up our Raspberry Pi, and for that we require a micro USB cable just like that, and gently insert it over here, the power jack. And for the internet connection, there are two options. First of all, this here is an Ethernet cable or a LAN cable. Now gently insert it over this Ethernet jack, and you are done with the connections part. Now, for the other internet connection, we can also have a adapter, a wireless nano USB adapter, just like that, and you can have on the USB port. Now we need our ADC analog to digital converter, that is ADS1114, and this here is a connecting cable. Now make sure while making the connection among the cable and the ADC, the brown wire of the cable should be connected to the ground terminal of the ADC, and similarly we have to follow this rule for the ground terminal of the I2C shield. Now we are done with all the concerned connections for the hardware. Now let's have a look over the code. Alright, in the instructions part for the interfacing section, we have to log in to github.com, and here we have to search on for the repository, that is Control Everything Community. And after that we have the ADC, that is ADS1114, and there we are with the code, with the Java code as you notice, and we have to fulfill the instructions part first. As you see, we have to download and install Pi4J library on the Raspberry Pi, and this link pi4j.com will help us to do the installation carefully onto the Raspberry Pi for Pi4J library. As you notice, all the relevant installation process commands are there. Please do it carefully. After that, we have to download the code onto the Raspberry Pi, and this is the command for the compilation, and this is for the running of the Java code. Now note it down carefully, and after that, get back to the Java code. And also it's a .java extension file. Now in the notice, in the code, you notice that we have imported some of the libraries from the pi4j.com main library and public.class created for ADS1114. Now we have bus.get device, which will check whether the address of the device is 0x48 or not. Then we have a byte, as you can see, an array for the data for 0x84, 0x83, and it is, as you notice, I will explain it why we are here. And we have to select configuration register having address 0x01, and positive end will be AIN0, AIN negative end, that will be AIN1, and plus minus 2.048 volt, which will be the voltage reference, continuous conversion mode 128 SPS. This is the data here, like here, and we are writing it on the configuration register here. After that, we are going to read 2 bytes of the data from the register 0x00, and then we have the conversion of the data takes place here, which we have followed using the instructions of the ADC, that is ADS1114. At the very end, we have the output data to be displayed onto the screen, which is the digital value of analog input, and here we are with the code. Now what do we need is to look over the working. Now let's have a look over the working part, and for that we need to copy this entire code. And now let's have a look over the terminal we have connected for the Raspberry Pi via internet. And here we need to create a new file, as you are able to see on my screen. It's a .java extension file, and let's proceed with the pasting of the code, and after that we need to save it. And this command, as you know, will definitely compile the code, as you are able to see on my screen. And let's see how it is compiled. The code has been compiled successfully. Now we need to run the code, and this is the command for that. And as you know, we have the value, digital value of analog input. It's coming a random value because the ends are open and there is nothing connected. But instead, when I try to connect a AA battery of 1.5 volt across the two ends of the sensor and run the command again, we have the value, as you are able to see on my screen. And when I run it again, we have the value, and it's almost constant because there is nothing really changing according to the ends of the voltage. Now, what do we require next is to look over the applications and the features. The ADS1114 is the precision analog to digital converter with 16 bit of resolution. The ADS1114 featured an onboard reference and oscillator. Data are transferred via an I2C compatible serial interface. Four I2C slave addresses can be selected. The ADC1114 operates from a single power supply ranging from 2.0 volt to 5.5 volt. The concerned applications regarding this ADC due to high accuracy analog to digital conversions are portable instrumentation, consumer goods, battery monitoring, temperature measurement, and a lot more to mention. Well, you can have this sensor and you can purchase it from controleverything.com, and you can get the code from ResourceTab. From this site, you can download the code as a zip file. Also, you can get the code from github.com, and the repository there is controleverything community. In the end, I would like to make it clear that if you have any doubt regarding any part of this sensor or video, you can have your queries on controleverything.com, and you can post your comments on the community page on this website. For articles and blogs, you can have a look over on instructables.com. And to subscribe more video tutorials like this, you can have a look over our YouTube channel. In the end, I hope you enjoyed this video and had a good one yourself. Thanks a lot for watching.